Control car is the 16th, and 17 of Purdy takes off before the cone, and that's not going to play well.
Maybe we're confused, Dave. Maybe Purdy was the leader, but no. NASCAR's going to black flag him quickly.
There's no question about jumping the restart there. So this is going to be your battle for the win right here. The 16 of Gilliland on the outside. There's the black flag for Purdy, and now Burton down to the inside.
And see, Harrison used him up right there. Just what I said I would do. He used up a lot of racetrack right there. He drove it in really deep. Two to go. Now can Todd get back to do it to him?
Slide job to get the lead. Contact coming out of turn four. Harrison Burton gathers it up as the white flag comes out. Burton now down the backstretch. Can Gilliland get close enough to return the favor? He's on his bumper in turn four. Just a little bit of a slide from Burton. Here they come to the line. It's going to be Harrison Burton at South Boston.
What a big win for the family. What a big win for that young man. He's going to be elated.
All opened up by the fact that the second place car, Chase Purdy, jumped the restart.
Yeah, and you know, the truth of the matter is, Dave, that Chase Purdy, again, David Gilliland owns Chase Purdy's car. I hate to keep saying that, but he cost Todd Gilliland the win tonight. Because if you look right here on this restart, it looks like Chase decides that he's the leader of the race. He just goes away. Todd doesn't go. Todd should have gone ahead and gone right then. They would have still black flagged Chase Purdy because he was not the leader and jumped it, but he waited. It gave Harrison the opportunity. Look at it again right here.
And watch where the orange cone is on the left there. That's the restart line. They don't even come close to that before he starts rolling.
No, he starts to roll, but right there, Todd Gilliland should have started to roll as well. He doesn't. He hesitates. Now Harrison's got to run on the bottom right there, allows him to get in there and do the slide job the next corner.
Look at Marty Lindley. Is he a happy guy? His dad, Butch, won the second ever Xfinity Series race here at the South Boston Speedway back in 1982, and now he'll go to victory lane with this guy, young Harrison Burton, South Boston's most recent winner.
Chase Cabry was the reason for the caution, and now he come back to the green, ready to finish off the 2017 season. Here we go. Fourth or better is all he needs. Harrison Burton leads him to the green.
He got a bit of a push from Tyler Dipple, and he's able to clear them down into turn one. And now, just focus forward in that 12 car. Come get you a championship, Harrison Burton.
Hit your marks. And you heard Marty Lindley talk about it. There's a lot of stuff out on the racetrack from all the incidents today. You're just keeping your fingers crossed. You don't find any of that as a white flag is unfurled in front of him.
Saw a couple cars get together there off of turn four. All clear. Just two more sets of corners, Ralph.
Victory number five of the 2017 season will come at Dover for Harrison Burton. But the big payday today is the 2017 NASCAR K&M Pro Series East Championship, which goes to Harrison Burton. Mom Kim, Dad Jeff celebrating as their son is a NASCAR champion here today at the Monster Mile.
What a great moment. What a great shot. And congratulations to the Burton family. That was a real family effort this whole season.
We'll be right back to talk to the newly crowned champ.